us direction from above. We need a word from the Lord.
If a preacher's on the board, then his church needs to be given to this ministry.
Just one word. Hello. From the Lord.
So lead us, we have to lead the way.
Amen.
Hello.
And cause yeah. the sun to shine and give us peace.
From what I heard, I failed a whole lot. But you know what? That's okay.
That's all right.
That's all right. You fail. We all fall. I fail in many different ways.
You're right, man.
But the problem is, it's not that you fall.
Come on now.
The problem is, if you don't get up.
All right. My Lord.
And that's what renewal is. Sometimes we have to renew ourselves to the things of God. Because sometimes we get a little rusty. Hello? Sometimes we get a little traditional. Hello? But if we renew ourselves to a living God, we won't have dead thoughts.
All right.
And we'll be living and we'll be changing. And let me say this, because this is how to have self-control month.
Mm-hmm.
Leaders, you know, you don't have to be perfect. But what you do need to be is striving.
Come on,
right? Oh, Lord.
In those areas that you know, I don't even have to name it. The Holy Spirit has already told you.
Mm-hmm.
That's wrong.
Mm-hmm.
You have to be committed to not giving up on your fight to take self-control of your life. My body don't tell me what to do. I tell it.
All right. Amen.
It's a challenge.
Yes.
Yes, it is.
Hello. I have to tell it. Sometime now, you ain't hungry.
All right.
You ain't hungry. That's my battle, boy. Especially being here, boy. Y'all treat me so good.
All right.
If I wasn't fighting, I really would be a big preacher. I was joking with my wife. I said, you know, I want to be used of God in a great way. And I noticed that most of them preachers are kind of big men.
My Lord.
So I want to be big. She was like, she wasn't trying to hear that. No. No. We have to renew ourselves to the covenant.
Yes, Lord.
And the covenant is what? The word of God. So this morning, that's what we're going to do. We're going to all enter into a covenant relationship with God.
Yes.
Oh, like Jesus was in a covenant relationship with God.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to go over these points in the covenant. And we want leaders and followers to follow these points during this year. Pay close attention. Take notes. First of all, we're going to renew ourselves to the covenant of protecting the unity of our ministry. What we're going to do? By acting in love towards other leaders. Whoa. That's one of the biggest problems we have.
Yeah.
Wow.
Somebody over ministry, and you give them a position under, and they don't want to follow the vision of those who are in leadership.
Mm-hmm.
You follow that person's vision.
Mm-hmm.
When I was at E.K. Bailey's church in Dallas, Texas, it wasn't my job to try to take his church.
That's right.
Oh, it was my job to buy in and to work his vision until I could get to Paul's Valley and do my own vision.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Hello?
My Lord.
We have to refuse to gossip. Hello?
All right.
Leaders don't need to be gossiping. Hello? Because if you're gossiping, you're using words that you could actually be sharing alone.
All right.
Hello?
Well.
Hello?
That was real.
We're going to be committed to follow God, the pastor, and the leaders of Bethlehem. We're going to seek reconciliation when there's a broken relationship through scriptural methods.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the vow we're going to place our hands on the Bible, and we're going to bow to that. Number one, number two, and you can get this a little later. We're going to bow to, I will share the responsibility of my ministry by what? By praying. Amen. You know what we do in this church is a spiritual thing. And there shouldn't be one meeting that shouldn't be started with prayer.
Amen. All right.
There shouldn't be one leader that's not praying for their ministry.
Amen.
And also we're going to do what? We're going to invite the unchurched to attend. Hello? I see when we invite them, when we truly invite on Share the Love Sunday, this place is full.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
But sometimes we get a little dry. We need to renew ourselves. So we have to invite them again. You don't have to, you may not be the one that they come on, but if they've been asked three times by three different people, then they would have to be rebellious to the voice of God. They say, wait, God's trying to tell me something. Hello? And also, we do what? By warmly welcoming those who visit. Hello?
Yes.
Be warm, invite them. Don't just endure the time of talking. Don't just go to the people that you know. The most important thing is the people that you don't know.
Amen.
Embrace them. Hug on them. Love on them.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen.
Number three. You will... And this is where we're going to lay our hands on the covenant of the Bible, and we're going to swear this morning, or we're going to promise, is I will serve in the work of the ministry by discovering the gifts, my gifts and talents.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to start a new class this year called Christianity 101. And that's going to be the place where we want all new members to go. And one of the things that we're going to deal with in that class is spiritual gifts.
All right.
We're going to also, by being equipped to serve by the leaders. Leaders, you should be equipping others to serve if you are gone. That's what the office is all about.
Right.
One, as my wife likes to say, one monkey don't stop no show.
You're right.
And if it does, who are you serving, God or man?
Mm-hmm.
We all must develop a servant's heart. And we all must develop others to serve with me in the work of Christ. Some people, they get in leadership and they think they got to do everything.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. No, you don't have to do everything.
Mm-hmm.
You can't.
Just
that's why you'll see me doing a little more, letting the preachers preach a little more. Because I can't do it all by myself.
All right. Amen.
Oh, number four, we're going to all, the whole church, the greatest to the least, going to put our hands on the Bible, the covenant, and say that we will support the integrity of our ministry. How will we do that? By active participation. You cannot be changed or taught the covenant of God by being here only sometimes. You know what I notice? Is when I prepare a message and I think about some people that need to hear it, normally they're not here to hear it. Why is that?
Because it's the devil keeping
you away. Because the devil trying to keep you away from the word specially designed for you.
TaylorMade!
And you don't show up and don't hear from God and get stuck in your misery. This is key, leaders, and all of us. We have to live a godly life.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
This is a church, not a social club.
Amen.
Say that.
Amen.
Hello?
Amen.
In a social club, you live how you want. In a church, we're all to be molded and made into the image of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm.
Hello?
Mm-hmm.
And also, by giving regularly to the work of God.
Mm-hmm.
We have some big plans here, you know? We have some big plans, some big dreams, some big visions. We want to build a church that's probably going to wind up being the full cost, or I don't know if we're going to pay the whole cost, but probably from $1 million to $1.5 million. And if the Lord gives us more, hey, we'll do more.